Hi little ones, how are you? Hope you are fine and you are staying safe at home. Okay, let us start with our IT. You have been studied computer in class 1 and 2. So let us start with your third standard. Now you have reached third standard. What is the lesson name? The computer system. Okay. Now you have seen the computer, okay? You know there is a monitor, a keyboard, CPU, and a mouse. Now, computer system is made up of two components. You know how many components? Two components. And what's the name of those two components? One is hardware and the other one is software. So, which are the two main components of a computer system? Hardware and software. Now let us do one exercise. Will you follow me? Okay, just touch your head. Yes, very good. Touch your ears. Very good. Touch your nose. Wow. So you know you can touch your head, you can touch your ears, as well you can touch your nose. This same like that, there are computer parts. You know which are the computer parts? Yes, keyboard, monitor, speaker, mouse. These all are the computer parts. Can we touch them? Yes, obviously we can touch them. And it is also connected to it. That is why we call these parts as the hardware. Now, can you tell me what is hardware? Yes. Parts of a computer that we can touch and we can connect to it is called a hardware. So what do you mean by hardware? Like keyboard, mouse, printer, speaker, whatever. These parts, the parts which we can touch and see as well we can connect to it is called as hardware. The next component of a computer is software. What it is? Software. So hardware, let us define what is hardware. Hardware means it is a part of a computer that can be touched and connected to it. Understood? Okay. Next one is hardware examples. You know what is this? This is a keyboard. Okay. This is monitor. Very good. This is a printer. What about this? Yes, it is a speaker. And this one, you are well aware of it. This is a mouse. So these are the examples of hardware. Understood? Next one is, you will be wondering how does a computer work, right? You will be thinking, ma'am, how does a computer work? So let us study in detail about it. A computer works in three basic steps. How many steps? Yes, three basic steps. The first one is input, second step is process, and the third one is output. Will you please tell along with me? Input, process, and output. How many steps are there? There are three steps involved. Which are the three steps? First one is input, the second one is process, and the third one is output. Is it okay? Shall we say it once again? Input, process, output. Once again, input, process, output. Okay, so just say along with me. Input, process, and output. I'll give you an example of it, okay? What do you mean by input? What do you mean by processing? And what do you mean by output? Now, let us first check what is input. Suppose I want to make a milkshake. So, what is the procedure for that? I will have to collect the materials. What will be the materials? The materials will be obviously water, milk and sugar. These are the input. Okay, the materials which you are going to put inside is called input. What are the materials? Water, milk and sugar. Then what we will do next? The next step is we will add it. We will mix it together, right? So the process, the mixing is the process. When we mix the water, the milk and sugar, it is called as processing. What it is? Yes, it is called as processing. And then what is output? Yes, you are correct. Milkshake is the output. That is the thing we are making here, right? So, when, how does the computer work? Once again, input, process, output. Now, I will give you another example. This is what you do it daily in your home. What is that? Preparing a tea. You all may be preparing tea for your mother, right? Okay, let us prepare a tea right now. What will be the input for it? Yes, when there is a kettle, you will take a kettle switch and then you will add water to it and then you will add sugar. After that, you will add tea powder and the kettle will start boiling. That means the tea is ready. And when we put it in a cup, it is called the output. So, in that also, it is working as input, process, output. What is input over here? Water, tea, sugar and tea powder. This is the input. And what is the processing over here? The water is boiling. That is called the processing. And what will be the output? Obviously, you are correct. Tea. Tea is the output. Hope you might have understood what is input, process, output. Now, why do we use this input devices? Do you know why do we use input devices in computer? Okay, let me tell you. Input devices are used to put data and instructions into the computer. How we are giving information to the computer? By using the input devices. So, why do we use input devices? It is used to put data and instructions into the computer. Now, what is the use of a processing device? Processing devices are used to process data. Data means information. What are the information? The information which we give to the computer. So, what do you mean by processing? Processing means giving data and instructions. What are the instructions we are giving to the computer for doing calculations? Suppose I want to search anything on the computer, internet. That is the instructions we are giving. So, what is the computer doing over there? It is processing. What? Processing. Okay. And the last one is output devices. Why do we use output devices? Yes, it is used to display the results after processing of the data. When the processing is over, the result is produced by using the output devices. So, let us revise once again. What is our lesson name? Yes, the computer system. And what did we study? There are two main components of computer system. One is hardware and the other one is software. What is hardware? Hardware are the parts of a computer we touch and is connected to it. And what is software? Software means the instructions, the data we give to the computer. And what are the examples of hardware? We studied keyboard, mouse, CPU, monitor and etc. How does the computer work? How many steps are there? Three basic steps. They are input, processing, output. For input, we use the input devices. For processing, we use the processing device. And for producing result, we use the output device. Thank you. Have a nice day.